we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Algebra. The problem is on maximal ideals, and this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 16th February 2022, and it is from the section B. The problem is, which of the following statements is necessarily true for a commutative ring R with unity? We are given two options. Option 1, R may have no maximal ideals. Option 2, R can have exactly two maximal ideals. Option 3, R can have one or more maximal ideals but no prime ideals. Option 4, R has at least two prime ideals. We have a commutative ring R with unity, and the question is about whether the ring R admits maximal ideals or admits no maximal ideals, can admit exactly two maximal ideals, and so on and so forth. So the problem is on the concepts of maximal ideals and prime ideals of a commutative ring R with unity. Before discussing the problem, let us recall the following results. Theorem: if R is a non-zero ring with unity and I is an ideal in R such that I not equal to R, then there exists a maximal ideal M of R such that I is contained in M. So we have a non-zero ring R with unity, and I is an ideal in R which is not equal to R, then there always exists a maximal ideal M of R such that I is contained in M. This tells you the existence of a maximal ideal in these circumstances. We use John's lemma to prove this result. And we have another theorem what we are going to use. If R is a ring with unity, commutativity is not required here. If R is a ring with unity, then every maximal ideal is a prime ideal. Now what about the converse? But the converse in general is not true. And an example for the converse is not true is the following. The ideal, that is the zero ideal, the ideal generated by zero in the ring of integers is a prime ideal, but it is not a maximal ideal. So let's now get into the problem and discuss the solution in detail. And these above theorems are listed as theorem 6.1 and theorem 4.5 in the book Basic Abstract Algebra by Bhattacharya, Jain and Nagpal, and it is from the Cambridge University Press, and it is the second edition, 1995. In this book you can see these results. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We have R, a commutative ring with unity. Because it is a ring, it should be at least have an element 0, and it has a unity, therefore R will have at least two elements, that is 0 and 1. So it is not a non-zero ring. Now let us take the statement that is given in option 1. R may have no maximal ideals. Is it true? That's the question. So if there exists, if we can show that there exists some maximal ideals, then this statement is false. Now we have R, a commutative ring with unity, and we use this result. R has two ideals, namely zero ideal and R. Always every ring R has these two ideals. They are trivial ideals. We have the following result. If I is an ideal in R such that I is not equal to R, then there always exists a maximal ideal M of R such that I is contained in M. And we use John's lemma to prove this result. You can see this result as theorem 6.1 on page 211 of the book Basic Abstract Algebra by Bhattacharya, Jain and Nagpal. And this shows that every commutative ring with unity has a maximal ideal. Therefore, the statement R may have no maximal ideals is not true. Therefore, the option 1 is not true. Let's move to the next option. Option 2. R can have exactly two maximal ideals. It says, so if you can expect, can have means if you can exhibit a ring R which admits exactly two maximal ideals, then this statement is true. So to say so, we consider this example Z6 under addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6. It is a commutative ring with unity. Right. Now, its ideals are, first, zero ideal, that is, the ideal generated by zero consists of zero element alone. And the whole ring Z6, these are two trivial ideals. And now, bracket 2, that is, the ideal generated by 2, consists of 0, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, and 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is, 3 times, that is, 6. Modulo 6, addition modulo 6 is 0. So this is the ideal generated by 2 consists of 0, 2, 4. The ideal generated by 3 consists of 0 and 3. So these are the four ideals that this Z6 admits. And let's look at the lattice structure of the ideals of Z6. So Z6 is here, and the ideal generated by 2, the ideal generated by 3, yes, and the trivial ideal consisting of 0 element alone is like this. This is the lattice structure of the ideals of Z6. In this, what you see is the ideal generated by 2 is a maximal ideal. Why? Because it's an ideal of Z6. And between these, between Z6 and ideal generated by 2, there is no proper ideal. That is, there is no ideal properly contained in between these two. Therefore, it's a maximal ideal. So also in this case, bracket 3 is also maximal ideal. So note that bracket 2 and bracket 3, that is the ideal generated by 2 or the ideal generated by 3, are the only maximal ideals of Z6. So here is an example that Z6 has exactly two maximal ideals of Z6. Therefore, our option 2 is true. Therefore, R, which is a commutative ring with unity, can have exactly two maximal ideals. Thus, the option 2 is true. Let's move to the next option. Option 3, R can have one or more maximal ideals but no prime ideals. That means, is there a situation where R has maximal ideals, but it has no prime ideals. Is it the case? Now, if R has one or more maximal ideals, then R has one or more prime ideals. Why? Because every maximal ideal is a prime ideal in a ring with unity. Why? Because every maximal ideal in a ring with unity, we don't require commutativity, is a prime ideal. So every maximal ideal is a prime ideal in a ring with unity. So this is not true. So the option 3 is not true. Let's go to the last option. Option 4. R has at least 2 prime ideals. So R has at least 2 prime ideals, and if you can show that there is a commutative ring with unity which has only one prime ideal, then it will be false. Let R be a field. Okay, so R is a field, means it is a commutative ring with unity, definitely. Let us take, why not take that field as this field of rational numbers Q plus dot. And it is a very well known result that the trivial ideals are the only ideals of a field. So its only ideals are the ideal generated by 0, the whole of Q. Now Q is not maximal. Why? Why? A maximal ideal, it must be a proper ideal of Q. So Q is not maximal since it is not a proper ideal of Q. To be maximal, it should be a proper ideal of Q. Therefore, Q is not maximal. Therefore, the ideal generated by 0, that is the 0 ideal, is the only maximal ideal of Q. That means in the case of the fields, it admits only one maximal ideal. Thus, the option 4 is not true. So, we have only one true statement. That is the option 2. So the answer is option 2. So that is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section algebra, and the problem is on maximal ideals. And I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out problems related to maximal ideals and prime ideals from the ring theory. I wish you all the best. Thank you.